In order to implement the PI controller for any application, first we need to find the error between the reference value and the actual value. Generally we write error as reference value minus actual value. But the important question here is that, will this equation holds true all the time? Or can we have a situation like, where the error is written like, actual value minus reference value? Or minus reference minus actual value? Or reference value plus actual value? So in today's video, I'm going to explain you the fundamental concept behind this. With the help of MATLAB, I will give you the detailed explanation on how to write the error equation while implementing the PI controller. This is the closed loop simulation of a buck converter that I made long back. I am using this simulation to explain you the concept of writing the error term while implementing PI controller. Here I sense the output voltage and compare it with the reference value to find the error. Error is then fed to API controller. Output of the controller is compared with the carrier signal and generate the PWM signals. Here you can clearly see that I wrote the error as V reference minus V actual. And that is how we usually write the error term for API controller. Now I will just run the simulation and show you the output. So here you can see that the output coming is same as the reference. Now just change the reference and see the output. The output is also changing with the change in reference. So this simulation is working perfectly fine. Now I will just brief the working of the controller. Initially, the output voltage is zero. Therefore the error will be a positive value. When the error is positive, the output of the PI controller starts increasing. And hence the duty ratio also increases. Therefore the output voltage starts going up. Once it goes above the reference value, the error becomes negative. Therefore the PI controller output starts decreasing. And hence the duty ratio also decreases. Which make the output voltage coming down. This procedure keeps repeating, and finally the system arrives at an equilibrium point, where the output voltage will be the same as the reference value. Now suppose, someone else is simulating this circuit, and he has the PWM logic opposite to what I have here. One thing is to remember is that, anyone can have any logic for PWM implementation. It is all up to the designer, who is designing the circuit. So I will change the sign of this block to less than or equal to. Now let's run the simulation and see the output. You can clearly see that the output voltage is not same as the reference value. Since we changed the PWM logic, the circuit is not working properly. So we need to do some modification in order to make the circuit working. That I will show you now. For that, we need to enable this circuit. And let's disable this one. The circuit is same as the previous circuit, except two changes. I have reversed the PWM logic that I have already mentioned. And the important change is that, I have modified the error term. Instead of V reference minus V actual, it is now V actual minus V reference. Now let's run the simulation and see the output. We are getting the correct output now. So the important point here is that writing the error term is depending on the PWM logic we are using. Depending on the logic, it can be either V reference minus V actual or V actual minus V reference. Now I will keep the PWM logic in its original position. But changing the output voltage sensing point. I am just reversing its connection. One thing you have to remember is that the designer can connect the sensor in whatever direction he wants, especially when it comes to AC current and voltage. Now let's run it and see what is happening. You can clearly see that we are not getting the correct output. Again, we need to do some modification to make the circuit working. For that, we need to disable this circuit and enable the other circuit. Here I have reversed the sensor connection. This is the PWM logic. And the important change I made is that, I wrote the error term as V reference plus V actual. Now run the simulation again. See, we are getting the correct output now. So the point everyone needs to understand here is that, similar to the PWM logic, sensor connection also decides how to write the error term. And it can even take the form V reference plus V actual. Now here, if I reverse the PWM logic also, then we will not get the correct output. Then again we need to modify the controller to make it work, that I will show you now. So let's go to our fourth circuit, where both PWM logic and sensor connection is reversed. Let's disable this one and enable the final circuit. So here I have changed the sensor connection. PWM logic is also reversed. And the important change is that the error term is now minus V reference minus V actual. Now if we run this simulation, you will get the correct output. So the point I would like to tell you is that, if you change both the sensor connection and PWM logic, the error term can even take a form minus V reference minus V actual. So I am concluding this discussion here by saying, when you implement API controller, the error term can be written like V reference minus V actual or V actual minus V reference or V actual plus V reference or minus V reference minus V actual, depending on the PWM logic and voltage current sensor connection. Hope you have understood this very important concept. With that note, I am ending this video here. Thanks for watching.